Multichess Leg und E-Trunk. E-Trunk stands for Enhanced Trunk. It implements link aggregation between two devices, PEs, connected to one service node, CE. CE nodes can be dual-homed to two PEs with device-level link protection based on Link Aggregation Control Protocol, LASP. LASP must be working between the CE device and the PEs. E-Trunk is used on Ethernet interfaces to provide L2 VPN or L3 VPN services to CEs with having redundant PEs. Service configuration is shared on the PEs. One PE will only be active at a time to provide services to the CE node. The other PE is a standby. In this lab, we will implement E-Trunk between PE1, PE2, and CE4. We will configure E-Trunk from PE1 and PE2 side and attach the E-Trunk on interface 001 and 003 from PE1 and PE2 sides. After we finish the configuration and establish the E-Trunk, we will have only one interface 001 or 003 as the active interface. The other interface will be standby, not handling traffic, based on which device is active and which device is standby on the E-Trunk configuration. These are the configuration steps that we are going to follow in the lab. 1. We are going to create E-Trunk on each PE. 2. Create Ethernet trunk with LASP mode on each PE and add Ethernet interfaces to Ethernet trunk created on each PE. 3. Create Ethernet trunk with LASP mode on CE side and add Ethernet interfaces connected to two PEs. Let's start with the lab configuration now. Let's get started with PE1 device. First, we will undo terminal trapping, not to get terminal trapping messages during our configuration. Then we will go to the system view and create a trunk and give it a number as 1, 2, or 12. On the E-Trunk view, we'll specify the peer address. The peer address, which is the peer device we need to create the E-Trunk with, which is PE2. So peer address, and specify the loopback address of the peer device, which is PE2, 2.2.2.2, and the source address as 1.1.1.1. Then quit from the E-Trunk view. Now it's time to configure the Ethernet trunk with command interface Ethernet trunk 1.2. I'll give it 1.2 as well. And specify its mode as LSP static. Then quit from the Ethernet trunk 12. Now it's time to attach the physical interface 001 in Ethernet trunk 12. Interface giga 001. And we attach this physical interface to Ethernet trunk 12. In interface Ethernet trunk 12, we will configure E-Trunk 1.2. Now we have configured Ethernet trunk 12 with LASP mode and attached E-Trunk 12 to this Ethernet trunk 12. I'll save the configuration and do the same with device PE2. Let's undo terminal trapping, then to the system view and create etrunk 12. Peer address this time is PE1, which is 1.1.1.1, and source address is 2.2.2.2. Then we configure the Ethernet trunk 12 we created and set its mode as LSP static and add etrunk 12 to the Ethernet trunk 12. Finally, the physical interface must be attached to Ethernet trunk 12. The physical interface this time is 003 from PE2 side. Ethernet trunk 12 on the interface view of Giga Ethernet 003. After we finished the configuration on PE1 and PE2 sides, I'll go to the CE device, which is CE4, and I'll configure a normal Ethernet trunk interface. I'll give it a number 4, Ethernet trunk 4, and we will set its mode to LSP static as well. Then we will attach interface Giga Ethernet 001 to Ethernet trunk 4. And we'll do the same with the other interface, which is 003. Undo terminal trapping to ask the system not to show these trapping messages. System view again, and the other physical interface is 003, must be attached to Ethernet trunk 4. After I configured Ethernet trunk 4 on Giga Ethernet 003, the system gives me an error. The port has other configurations. Please clear them first. So I'll check on the existing configuration using command display this, and I can find that this interface is configured with an IP address and description from the other lab. So I need to remove the IP address first. Undo IP address. Also, I can undo the description, but it's not a must to remove the description. Now I'll set interface Ethernet trunk 4 to be attached with Giga Ethernet 003. Now the system accepted the configuration and accepted interface 003 to be a member of Ethernet trunk 4. To verify that Ethernet trunk 4 now has two members from CE4 router side, interface 1 and interface 3, we simply AGU command display interface Ethernet trunk 4. Now we have two physical interfaces, 001 and 003. One interface is up and one interface is down. We don't have both interfaces in up state, because after we configured the etrunk from PE1 and PE2 side, the etrunk negotiates between the two devices PE1 and PE2, then selects one PE node to be the active and one PE node to be the standby. The node which is standby, its interface will be in a standby state, 003 from PE2 and 003 from CE4. Let's verify that from PE1 display etrunk 12. So I can see that etrunk 12 state master at PE1 display etrunk 12 from PE2 side. I can see that it's backup on PE2 device. Now we have configured the etrunk successfully between PE1 and PE2, and the etrunk selects one device to be master, which is PE1, and one device to be backup, which is PE2. How the devices is selected to be master or backup in etrunk? We have two criterias. The first one, smaller etrunk priority, reflects higher priority to be master. Means if we need to manually configure one device to be master, we must give this device a smaller etrunk priority. If we didn't configure the priority, the default is 100. It means that the devices of the etrunk, PE1 and PE2, will be configured with the same priority. So we will go to the second criteria. If we have same priority, the device with the smaller system ID is elected as the master. Let's check that on the lab. We have PE1 and we run before command display etrunk 12. We can find that the priority here is 100, and on PE2 display etrunk 12, we can find that the priority is 100 as well. So we have a tie on the priority. The second criteria is the system ID. On PE1, we can find that the system ID is this number, 54899896, and on PE2, 54899898D1. We have here 98D1 and 9896. This number is lower than PE2, so PE1 has a better system ID or a lower system ID, which means that this device will be elected as the master device on the etrunk. Its interface on the etrunk 001 will be active or up, and the interface of PE2, which is the backup side in the etrunk, will be 003 in the down state or the standby state. Now let's make a small test. I'll shut down the interface 001 and make sure that interface 003 is up. I'll go to system view of PE1 and go to interface 001, then shut down. Then check again display etrunk 12. I can find that PE1 is turned to backup state, and PE2 display etrunk, display etrunk 12, its state turned to be master, and from CE4 I can issue command display interface etrunk 4 and find that 001 is turned to the down state and 003 is turned to the up state. We have here this side from CE4 to PE2 is active now, and from CE4 to PE1 is standby. And that occurred because we have a failure, or the interface 001 is shut down on PE1. Thank you for viewing this video. I hope it can add a good value for you.